The South Dakota State football team continues its efforts to return to Frisco, Texas tomorrow, second round of the FCS playoffs, and it is a late start, 8 p.m. Central Time, as the Jackrabbits take on the Hornets of Sacramento State, the number 4 seed in the playoffs. First time ever these two programs get together. This is Gameday Eve. Hi, friends. Tyler Merriam. Great to be chatting with you again, because in just over 24 hours, SDSU and Sacramento State play a huge football game. The winner moves on to the final eight. The Jackrabbits had to play an opening round game last week on Thanksgiving weekend and were tremendous against UC Davis, a 56-24 win. Jacks actually trailed 10-7 early in the second quarter, but scored 21 points in the span of 5 minutes and 10 seconds to take control of the game. A school record 6 interceptions tied a record that was set back in the early 1950s. 3 of those by Dallas Beanham. Beanham returned one for a touchdown. Adam Bach also returned a pick for a score. Tremendous day for that Jackrabbit defense. Meanwhile, on offense, the playoff program record of 446 rushing yards established by Thunder and Lightning, the combination of Isaiah Davis and Pierre Strawn Jr. Davis, a career best 217 yards on the ground. Pierre Strawn Jr. added 185. Each of them found the end zone. And we can't forget about the fact that Strawn Jr. added to his perfect passer rating. It's impossible to have a more perfect union, as the Constitution says. It's impossible to be more perfect as a passer, but Pierre Strom threw a touchdown pass to Chris Oladokun to do that. And let's give a shout out to Gus Miller, because when a 605 Hog scores a touchdown, he deserves a tip of the hat, and Miller did that for SDSU's final tally of that 56-24 win. So the opposition out of the Big Sky Conference, Sacramento State. And Troy Taylor has done a phenomenal job, the young head coach of Sacramento State. Second time the program's been a top 8 seed. Now, to put things in perspective, Sacramento State played a couple of bowl games and then played 3 Division II playoff games in 1988. That was it for the postseason until Taylor arrived. In 2019, they were a top 8 seed but lost in round 2, their first game of the playoffs. They're a top 8 seed again. So what he's done in such little time in Northern California, nothing short of remarkable. 1-2 this team started, a loss at home to Northern Iowa, a loss on the road at Cal, but they were a perfect 8-0 in the Big Sky, tying a school record by winning 8 consecutive games to earn a top 8 seed. And part of the reason why is that they took tremendous care of the football and were advantageous in forcing turnovers during this 8-game win streak, a plus 12 turnover margin. They'll use 2 quarterbacks, and they are a little different, but both are very capable. Let's start with number 10, Asher O'Hara. O'Hara started the first 3 games, threw 74 passes in the first 2 games, but he's thrown 10 or fewer every game since. But he is the leading rusher on the team, 655 yards. He's not a true wildcat quarterback, though, because he is a quarterback and he can throw the football. He's very good in that regard. The other quarterback, number 12, Jake Dunaway. Dunaway has gone 96 consecutive passes without throwing an interception, and he's averaging 9.1 per pass attempt as far as yards gained. That's the 3rd most in the FCS. So Dunaway and O'Hara, both you will see at quarterback. They may change them out by drive, may change them out by play, but you'll see both early and often on Saturday night under the lights in Sacramento. First team all Big Sky tight end Marshall Martin, number 16, 47 receptions on the year for 6 scores. In the regular season finale, a win over UC Davis, he had a huge game, 6 receptions, 112 yards in that local rivalry known as the Causeway Classic. First team all Big Sky wideout number 84, Pierre Williams, has been hurt the last couple of weeks, expected to return. He ranks 4th in school history in career receiving yards, 6th in receptions, 8th in touchdowns. He is something else. 3 different running backs will make appearances. There isn't one guy in particular that stands out. You do have 21 B.J. Perkinson. He's put together over 1,400 career rushing yards. He's top 15 in program history, but he only has 1 100-yard game, just kind of the steady eddy of the program. Number 32, Cameron Scataboo, has really come on as of late. He's averaging better than 9 yards per rush, and in the last 5 games, He's rushed for 478 yards. The offensive line, it's an interesting combination of youth and experience. Left tackle, left guard are both freshmen, where center, right guard, right tackle are multi-year starters. That's how the O-line shapes up, and they're all very similar. They're all 6'3 to 6'5. They all weigh between 295 and 305. That's a look at the Hornets offense. Let's shift gears, talk about the Sacramento State defense. This is a team with 16 interceptions on the year. We talk about being advantageous as far as turnovers are concerned. That's the ninth most picks in the FCS. Holding teams to 18.5 points per game, and they have the eighth best red zone defense in all of the football championship subdivision. The two defensive ends anchor the line. That's Josiah Erickson, number 44, and 94, Wyatt Jelm. Erickson, by the way, seventh in program history in career tackles for loss, and this season he has already accumulated 9 quarterback sacks. Number 5, Marcus Hawkins, leads the linebacking crew. He has a team-best 74 tackles. He's made 13 tackles in the backfield this year, 5 quarterback sacks for Hawkins. And they have 2 different defensive backs who have 4 interceptions this year, both with great names, Munchie Filer II and Marte Mapu, each with 4 INTs to lead the way for what is a talented secondary at Sacramento State. Excellent in the special teams game is Troy Taylor's Hornets. Kicker Kyle Sankowski, a school record 19 field goals this year. He's 19 of 23. His long is 51. The punter Sam Clark ranks 6th in the country in yards per punt at 44.5 per kick. They don't return many kicks. Similar to SDSU, often it's a fair catch, but Devin Gandy does have a 94-yard kickoff return this year. Should be noted that under Troy Taylor in his 2 years, they didn't play in 2021 spring competition, so just 2019 and then this 2021 fall campaign. The Hornets are 14-0 when they take the lead. So they're 14-0 when they score first. They're 16-0 when they lead after 3 quarters. Couple of things to keep in the back of your mind as you watch this playoff game, which will take place tomorrow night, 8 o'clock Central Time, exclusively on ESPN+. Or you can listen to Alex Parker, Scotty Quaz, and myself. Our pregame coverage starts at 7 o'clock. South Dakota State, with a record of 9-3 against 9-2, the number 4 seed Sacramento State from Hornet Stadium in Sacramento, California. Should be a fun one tomorrow night in Northern California.